today on Building Stuff with Doggy Dove. Docking point extenders. And astronaut sleeping quarters. The docking port extender has been a very important tool since the very beginning of spaceflight. It allows for craft to have more maneuverability between each other and to dock further apart for easier equipment transfer. This also acts as a nice tunnel for crew to pass through as they exit a spacecraft into another. This is a large pressurized space, but it is easily pressurized by the life support systems on both craft. Some may say this dates back many, many years, and while it does, it has only been used in recent spaceflight history. Meaning, since the beginning of spaceflight, since it hasn't been happening very long on the beautiful planet of Drew. Now let's dive into how they actually make these tubes of steel. This factory likes to start from a big rocket. Then they'll tear the tube off and use the capsule as a good idea for scaling. Then they position their camera to a decent spot. After this, they scroll through some tabs until they find the proper tab. After the tab is found, they bring a part out into the workspace. Then they screw around a little bit before shortening the part. Now this factory will grab two docking ports to put on either end of the steel tube after moving it down a little bit. Docking ports are installed with drill bits to cut the hole where everything will go through. One docking port has to be flipped in order to be attached to the other side. This company then likes to put their steel tubes on a lathe to get the proper size. Then they sand the surface clean. This factory likes to use a little bit of additive manufacturing to get that good quality feel, and to put a layer of insulation inside the tube. Then they grab a fairing to use as a protective cap on top of both the docking port. They also put that on a lathe too. Then they copy and paste this part down to the bottom. This docking port extender is not finished yet, and now must go off to the paint booth. But first, they may find it fit to reorient the part. This factory likes to scroll through tabs before finding the proper paint tab. And then they paint the inside of the docking port. Once the docking port has been painted, it is now complete. That is how this factory makes docking ports start to finish. It can now be sent off on a rocket to be used in space. The astronaut sleeping quarters has been in service for many years. This is where the astronauts sleep, as sleep is a vital function of life. Without this, the astronauts simply could not survive in space. It has RCS blocks on it for easy maneuverability. This factory likes to grab a space habitat out of the toolbox, and then, after grabbing one, they resize it to the proper size. Now this factory grabs one of the green arrows and shrinks this tube. But first, they put it on a lathe and do some additive manufacturing. Then this factory scrolls through some tabs for no reason and selects the proper tab. They grab the tube and put it on the base of the capsule and put it on a lathe once more. This factory inspects the size, making sure it's correct, and then shrinks it down to the final size. Then they coat it in a layer of insulation to keep the heat in, because freezing in space is not something this company wants to happen. Then they use a special kind of copier to put a new part on the bottom already fixed with adhesive. Then they put the bottom parts on a lathe to get that nice circular shape, which the docking ports will be mounted on top of. Not jet engines, you idiot. Docking ports. This docking port needs to be flipped as it cannot be put on in that position. But first, they forgot to add one more part down at the bottom. Use a little bit of additive manufacturing before cloning the part and gluing it down to the bottom. Now the space habitat is ready to accept its docking port. They then rip a piece from the previous docking port extender and glue it down onto the space habitat. Then the habitat is disconnected and taken apart, mainly to get cloned. And then the bottom of that new one is taken off to get flipped. Then it is glued on top of the regular one. Now what this company likes to do is paint the docking ports before it is covered up by the command capsule. Why is there a command capsule? Because they have one. Don't question this company, they will come for you in your sleep. Trust me, it's happened to me before. I've ever since learned never to question this company. Now what they'll do is scroll through the tabs until they can find a command chip. Why does it take them so long? Dang it, I thought it was a command chip. If it appears, it is not a command chip. But it is, in fact, an interstage. This interstage will be a valuable part in order to keep everything on the outside of the tank on the outside until they no longer want it and can shoot it off into space. The symmetry mode will not work unless they put this on the space capsule. So maybe that's why it's there. Now what they can do is activate the symmetry mode, cloning four of these on the outside of the tank. These will be for the RCS blocks, and another pair will be made for the RCS fuel tanks. Now this company likes to grab parts to make the RCS blocks with. They put them on a lathe and shrink them. Never mind, these are RCS tanks. Then they grab a hemisphere with a drill bit inside to hollow out the tank. Then they clone the hemisphere flip it on its other side, and do the same to the bottom. Now they sand off the outside of the fuel tanks, giving them a nice smooth shine. Now they switch all the fuel to monopropellant and make the whole craft look better as a whole. It takes them a while to do this. Why are we showing you the whole thing? Good question. I have no idea. And yes, that is also not complete on the docking port. Now it is time to build onto the RCS blocks themselves. Despite their names, they will not actually be composed of blocks. They will instead be composed of tubes that have been thrown on a lathe. For some reason, they like making space parts with a lathe, and shrinking them like that. Unconventional building style, but it does work. Then they use additive manufacturing to bring it up to the size of an RCS nozzle. Stick another one on the bottom just to be sure. Then the tube is cloned to be put on the other side to make a four-way tube. Now that the tube has been made four-way tube, they countersink the other tube to make it look better. Remember, kids, vanity over quality. Now that the tube looks significantly better, they can think about removing the RCS block to add another way to put this. A new tube is cloned and positioned properly. Tube is resized and the main RCS block can be placed on perfectly. Once this company starts screwing around. Now they can place the RCS block on the tube and countersink it to make it look good. Then a new RCS nozzle is added to the end. For whatever reason, it does not like to stay connected. Now the RCS nozzle is attached, and the whole RCS assembly is moved in place. Now it takes a little bit of fine-tuning to get this perfect, but don't you worry, it has gotten perfect in the end. Just takes a little bit. The RCS brick is now perfect. Mostly perfect. Now some fine tuning is done to make it look better. One of those things being shaving off the outside coating of metal to make it look way better. Don't worry, this is automatically done on all sides, as this company uses some weird telekinesis. Now the habitation module is ready to accept its command chip. First, they take off the docking port for some reason, and stick it on the side of a capsule. I don't think that was supposed to happen. Now this company, if I remember correctly, will screw around for a minute before they actually get their whole command chip debacle sorted out. This is the moment where they realized they were dumb and didn't actually put the command chip in. But first, the actual RCS stuff is lowered into proper positioning. First, it is lowered too much, and then raised up to ensure it locks in place. Now with the RCS stuff all locked in place, a new command ship can be added to the craft. Once it is set as primary, they can now glue it back to the rest of the habitation module. That was a fatal mistake, you idiot. Try again. Now that they're in the middle of trying again, this will take a minute. Maybe longer than a minute. For some reason, the stupid command ship got reset. Nobody knows why. I still do not know why to this day that this happened, but it did happen. Now the top of the craft is chopped off and replanted for some reason. It's not that hard, just take the stupid habitation module off and put it onto the actual thing. This is really infuriating me. Finally, they can... Oh, jeez. Okay. Take the command module. There you go. Now the habitation module is set, it is basically done. Just needs some testing to be done to make sure that the inner stages work properly. And that, my friends, is how astronaut sleeping quarters is made. Really cool. Now we go onto the quality control and test the thing. And you do see a loading screen in real life. This is how it works. Now that the craft is on the pad and the real world simulation is lagging extremely hard, the RCS is not tested. Okay, which idiot forgot to fill the tanks? It wasn't that guy in the corner, that's all I know. He's not in charge of fuel here. Now, they actually try to fuel up the rocket before launching it. I have just been informed this is not a rocket and still is the stupid habitation module. With the fuel in place, a test can be redone. This time, hopefully in success.